I'm the most surprised guy in the world to be sitting here, actually. I can think of a lot of people I would have picked before I would have picked me. So but I'm not going to second guess anybody.
Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars, and let me see what spring is like on a Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore.
It all starts with the soil and the rock. Mother Nature gave us the ground to build on, and when you understand the ground, you can build.
What Clyde does and has done extraordinarily well is to understand how those soils and rock materials react.
Hey Bill, how's it going?
We've developed theories in soil mechanics to explain how we think the ground is going to behave when you put load on it.
He's been instrumental in demonstrating that the ground can support an awful lot more than was previously thought. Increasing the stresses in the ground, he's able to reduce foundation costs and increase the sizes of the building.
If Clyde has done the geotechnical engineering, you can have high confidence that that building is going to stay where it was put.
And I think we discussed that interior-wise, the fill wasn't that deep.
I was working for my professor, and he had told me that Clyde Baker was the best foundation engineer in the world. So I thought, well, that's where I've got to go. I've got to work with the best. And you know, he was absolutely right. And I've been here for 16 years, and he's still right about that. He's definitely a very, you know, dynamic personality, and he's got charisma. So he's very good at taking charge of things and really just getting down to the very brass tacks of what people need to do, and then people listen to that.
I like the bolo ties or string ties. I like to buy individual ones that have been made, crafted by somebody. And then that's worth something, rather than a mass-produced tie. You know, 1,000 ties all, or 10,000 all look alike. I live in Chicago, I'm probably the only guy in Chicago that may be wearing them. I figure, why not? I had been a sort of a semi-track star in college at William & Mary. And I was a graduate student at MIT. I was trying to stay in reasonable condition. And the Boston Marathon was coming up. It was the 1953 Boston Marathon. So that was my one experience running the marathon until I started to close in on 40. And I ran a lot of marathons between age 42 and age 70.
He has a tiny little newspaper clipping in his wallet. And it shows that he was not just, you know, a runner, he was an extremely good runner.
There was one time when I was younger, I snuck out of the house, and he came after me, and I started running. Well, that was wrong, because I never could escape him. He ran and ran. I'm like, you know, okay.
What it says to me is that he's a high energy guy. If you've been around Clyde, his energy is almost infectious at times. He's bouncing around and, you know, from one thing to another, both intellectually and physically. And it was one of those things that just made you admire him even more.
I came to Chicago with the idea that I would do foundation engineering like we had done in the East, and do water resource engineering, and what I quickly determined, Clyde and his gang ruled this town.
Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I will show you around. I love it that your bottom dollar, you lose the blues in Chicago, Chicago. The town that Billy Sunday couldn't shut down. On stage.
State Street, that great street.
This is going to be the tallest building in North America, and as such, it's obviously a heavy building. And we wanted to come up with the most economical foundation system that we could.
We are constructing the core for the Spire Tower. 20 10-foot diameter rock caissons socketed 8 to 12 feet into rock.
Clyde gives wonderful rein to his engineers. He really delegates and teaches at the same time.
The smartest thing I ever did in my life was hiring Bill.
Well, thank you, Clyde.
You can follow in footsteps, but they're mighty big. And there's no Clyde Baker.
Clyde is one of the preeminent geotechnical engineers, certainly in this country, if not in the world. This is an outstanding engineer.
I was asked a couple years ago why I thought I had been successful in my career to the extent that I'd been successful. And I had said, you know, I had a whole list of things. And I gave the first and the last as the most important. If you associate with good people and you enjoy what you do, you're going to be successful. I do believe in taking opportunities as they come along and doing the best I possibly can. So I'm happy as a clam, you might say.